prior to you joining this program, about a half an hour ago, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers put out photographs of Tom Brady wearing his Buccaneer uniform for the very first time.
And you were so nice to send it to me.
Yeah, well,
the phone call to make sure I could take a gander.
You know, I just wanted you to have a frame of reference, you know, at the very least.
And you've always been a caring guy. It's a deserved reputation you have.
Thank you, Bill.
You always make sure everybody is taken care of. So I appreciate that, Rich.
So, I mean, what do you think, Bill? What do you think?
Well, you know, as an older guy myself, they could have done him a little better with some of the lighting on those. but
Yeah.
I would love for him to still be with the Patriots, but, like, he literally put the franchise on his back. Him and Belichick and Robert Kraft, like, made us an actual, like, one of the top franchises in the history of the NFL now. And before they all came along, I mean, we were a joke, you know? Chuck Fairbanks, very underrated, though, as a coach. As far as, dude, look at his 1974 draft. It was incredible. Or 73, I think it was the 73. 74 was the Steelers, had a great draft. But you know, he put us on the map. I mean, the guy, he won six. If he just won one, we would have named a street after him. He won six. He three-peated twice in the NFL. That never happens. We went to nine Super Bowls. I mean, all of a sudden, like, we became, during his time there, we became the team that went to the most Super Bowls. Like, all of a sudden, we came into the Dallas Cowboys 49ers stratosphere, which just seemed untouchable when I was growing up, when we had Paul Revere on the side of our helmet or whatever the hell that guy was supposed
Pat
to be.
The Patriot.
Yeah, Pat the Patriot. I mean, it's weird because the announcement happened during the pandemic, so everything kind of got, as far as the sports world, just got knocked down in order of importance. But now that they're showing that, as much as, you know, I'm bummed out that he's not with us anymore, there's two things that make me happy. One, football's coming back. That makes me psyched. And then two, you know, there's a lot of great quarterbacks throughout history finished on another team and never won a championship. So if he gets number seven, as far as modern-day athletes, he'll have one more than Jordan. I'm trying to think if anybody else got six.
No.
Maybe it was wasn't there a basketball player that kind of jumped around, had a few?
It could be Robert Horry.
No, Robert Horry.
I think Robert Horry, yeah. Could be.
That's five or six, right?
Could be. What do you
Charles
think?
Haley or somebody like that.
Yeah, Haley had, I think, five. Yeah, so, but what do you think of the fact, though, that, you know, you and I had spoken since Brady did leave. We haven't just seen him in the pewter and then the all-black uniform, and then he's in, they didn't put him in the old popsicle, creamsicle uniform, which is too damn bad, because that's the one I think that would be most difficult for you to handle. Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.